fundraisers in a year. We have the CCC, that happens in June. That's the crowdfunding one where all of you are a part. And then there's the CCR that just happened. So that's usually in November. So fundraising comes in, even though the university gives us, like I said, these millions of dollars to work with, there's always things that coaches like, I would really like to have more assistant coaching. I would really like to have another trip. I would really like to have more gear. I would really like to have, and they kind of like come up with different things that they would like. So we have teams, some teams are fundraising up to $300,000 on top of what the university is giving them. So that mostly is coming in the CCR. This is when coaches are going to people who they have in their networks that own businesses. They're contributing $5, $10, $15. We had a $100,000 gift come from one organization this year for Spartan Athletics at the CCR. So we just had that. We raised over $850,000. It was awesome. So a piece of that comes back to your track team. And then Shane gets to decide, okay, here's some money that we didn't know that we were necessarily going to have. Now we can dream, and now we can do some different things. The CCC in June, it started 2 years ago, because when I came here 4 years ago, I realized that at the time, Trinity was giving us athletic money, and they were giving us academic money. But if you got even $1 of athletic money, they said, we can't give you any need-based money. So some of you come from families who just don't have the means to be able to afford a place like Trinity. It's not cheap. No one is gonna say it's cheap. So need base was just taken off the table, and I get it. There's only so much money that Trinity has, and they're like, we're already giving you a lot of money to help the athletes, so we're just not gonna be able to give you the need base. And I'm like, that doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel right that I can't say to the need-based athletes, you know what, we can help you. So I said to the university, is it okay if we can stack it on top? That's why I built it like this. Can we stack the need-based on top of these other two things if we fundraise for it? They said, sure. So we had to come up with a way, how are we going to fundraise this? So that's where the CCC came out of. It was originally a golf tournament, but then COVID turned it into what we had to turn it into 2 years ago. And for those of you that were here, we asked everybody, can you do as best you can to come up with $300? So that's going to, maybe it's mom and dad, grandpa and grandma, aunts and uncles, brothers and sisters, old coaches. Maybe you even work for it. Some people just put in an extra shift at work, contributed it to themselves. We're asking for $300 of crowdfunded money, basically. So that gets us partway to this, because this need-based pot is 300K. Once we take all 400 athletes and go, okay, who needs need-based money and how much do you need? That's a $300,000 pool that we're trying to fill. So if we have 400 athletes all doing 300 each, quick math people in here, how far have we gotten out of to the $300,000 goal? No mathematicians in here. 120,000. Not even halfway, but it's a significant way. So we need you to each, when it comes around in June every year, and we kind of always hear a little bit of, how come I, this is why, because we are trying to help this group, because they didn't have the help before, and it makes a significant difference for them to be able to come to Trinity and be a part of your team. So that's what the CCC is, the CCR. Really, your coaches are not going to be asking you to fundraise beyond those two times. And really, the CCR, they're only going to talk to you if maybe your family has some kind of big business or something like that, because that's for the bigger donations. It's the CCC where it's kind of like, yeah, I'm going to talk to everyone in my network, see if I can get $5, $10, $25, $50, $100 to go towards this $300 goal. If you can, there was, what did one rugby player raise over 10 grand? Over 10 grand last year, because they're just like, yeah, I just asked a bunch of people, and people gave me way more than I needed, but I just gave it to the pot and blessed other people with it. So you can do that. Amazing. Then when you graduate and you become an alumni, we're asking, can you give back in one of three ways? We know that not everybody is necessarily going to be able to give back financially, so we're asking for either your time, your talents, or your treasure. So we just talked about the treasure piece. Maybe you're going to be blessed with a job that makes a ton of money. And you're like, you know what? You phone up Shane, you've been graduated for a year or two, and you're like, Shane, I'd like to give $1,000. The job I've been doing, God's blessed me, and I'm going to be able to donate $1,000. And Shane's like, please donate it at this because there's a big matching pot here. So this year the matching pot was $300,000. So for every dollar that came in up to $300,000, you got another dollar from the matching pot. Really helped Shane. Maybe you're going to come graduate, you're going to like, man, I got student loans. What could I do? I'm going to do $5 a month. So you just set it up. It just comes out of your account. It's $5 a month. You're like, really? Does $5 a month actually count? $60 a year? Are you kidding me? And you're like, Shane's like, no. Guess what? If I have 10 people graduate this year and 10 people graduate the next year and 10 people, and they're all just doing $5, again, it's just the power of crowdfunding. It does help. So if you've got the means and you have treasure that you'd like to donate back, amazing. But not everybody's going to necessarily have that. Some of you are going to have talent. Jamie is one of these people. He's got the talent of coaching. He graduates and he goes, you know what? I don't have a job that's making me $300,000 a year, but I have a desire to coach and I have some skills in that. So then he gets mentored by the coaches that are here. And now he's here and he's giving back by virtue of his talent. We're not asking Jamie to give $10,000 a year. He's already sacrificing a ton to be here and coaching, but that's he's giving back with his talent. And then some of you are like, well, I don't necessarily have treasure. I'm not really interested in coaching, but you know what? I still like to stay connected to the program somehow. So you contact Shane and say, Shane, how could I help? Maybe it's going to be in the area of discipleship. Maybe it's going to be in the area of just volunteering, helping do things in the community, and they're going to take that off Shane's plate because coaches are busy. They got a lot of things going on. So if you can think as you're graduating, how can I give back in one of these three ways? We just think that's a wonderful way to leave a legacy and not just a completely just walk away and never be connected with us again. All right, last thing, there is a group of from each team, as I've given this talk, you're the last group that we've talked to. If you're interested in leadership, maybe particularly like sport leadership or just the idea of like, what is it like to be a leader on a team? So if you've been a captain, maybe in high school you were a captain, you're young on this team, so you're like, oh, I'm not really a leader per se, but I'm still really interested, and I think by year 4 or 5, I might be a captain. Maybe you are a captain on this team, and you're like, yeah, I love reading books, I love listening to really good podcasts. There's not gonna be any homework, but there's a group called the Captain's Class that's getting together, and we're just gonna meet, we're gonna eat, we're gonna, again, listen to the podcast and just talk about what does leadership look like. So if that's interesting to you, I realize that there's lots of people like, that is the last thing I'm interested in. But if that's interesting to you, email me. I'll add you into the group, and then we'll set up the group on Teams, and then that's going to start here in December. So thank you. I know the cross-country people, you've already had your season. Well done.